Hey guys, St. Mac here, back with another Captain Tsubasa video. So it's Sunday, so I wanted to do one on League Mode. So if we check it out here, League Mode ends Sunday night. We have 4 hours left, and right now I'm looking pretty good. I'm in number 2,000, so not super high, but not super low either. And top 6,000 or so, like a little less than 6,000, get promoted this week. So everyone starts in League D, and then as you move up the ranks, you can basically get more points every week. And so this resets weekly. So weekly, you get these rewards that are based on what group you're in, so we're in Group D, and what place in the league we are. So if we check it out, like the top rank gets 50,000 league medals a week, and then it's half that, and then it's even less than half. It's half, even less than half of that, then it's half that again, and then it's a fifth of that of the lowest. So as you move up ranks, you get a lot more medals. So this week we're just gonna get 1,000 as a bonus, but then we'll get 5,000 next week once we're in C League, and then 10,000 when hopefully if we get promoted up to B League. But also, you get bonuses within those leagues as well. So, S League, we won't even really look at, but like if you're, okay, let's look at it real quick. So, if you're the top player in S League, you get 50 Dream Balls and another 50,000. So, you get 100,000 total that week. And then again, it goes lower as you're down. Like I'm sure it'll be really hard to compete for number one S rank against like some people who are buying a lot of orbs and stuff, but as we go down through the leagues, you're still getting quite a few dream balls up here. Like even in A league, if you're like let's see, if you're top 100, you're getting 5 balls, so that's pretty good. And you're still getting like 6,000 coins and stuff. B league, same kind of thing. I guess only top 10 gets orbs there, or sorry, balls there. But so we'll go down to where we are. And this is actually really slow scrolling. I'm gonna switch to actually using the phone. So we're actually in between 1,000 and 5,000, and that's just because everyone's in D League to start. This will become more dispersed as people play, and it'll be easier to get higher ranks as we go up. Like once everyone gets into kind of the tiers they should be in. But so this week we're expecting to get 1,500 on top of the 1,000 that we previously saw. So every week you get rewards, and it's based on, it's not like how many wins you have, it's your best win. So my best win here was 53,000. And to get promoted this week, you had to get at least 43,000. And then so what happens is you get these medals, and you get a lot of achievements and stuff for playing League Mode, and you get club experience, and I think you get money as well. But the main thing is you get these league medals. And so with these league medals, like right now I have 9,000, but if I get 250,000, which is quite a few, but you have 53 days to get it, you can get this SSR Teramasaki. But then there's also lots of other stuff you can get. Like you can get you can buy coins if you want. So very strong coins, you can go get the medals. You can buy notebooks, SSR notebooks. You can buy UR notebooks. You can buy drills to evolve your guys. And then I think the best things you can buy, yeah, they have like all the drills available. You can buy transfer tickets. So you can buy R plus transfer tickets. You can buy SR plus transfer tickets, and you can even get an SSR transfer ticket. Now, it's 600,000, so it's a lot of points. It's like more than 500,000 points. But I think if you get up in the ranks, and if you kind of save up the whole time, then you're most likely to be able to get it. You'll just have to be saving up. To be honest, I've been buying the R transfer tickets, just like hoping I get lucky and pull like an SR or SSR with them, because you can pull higher. You can, it's R or above, and they're pretty cheap. They're 12,000. So if you can still use like R and SRs, I'd recommend getting these first and then get moving to S the SR tickets. I'm just not 100% sure if people starting out, just the way you have to work up the tiers first, I don't know if 600,000 is super attainable for most people the first month or the first season. So I guess we'll see. There's also, yeah, you can also play formations. And these are decent looking formations. This one's really, I think the top one's probably the better of the two, because it's really offensive midfielder heavy. The middle one's really defensive midfield heavy, which is, I think that's like one of the hardest position to fill aside from goalkeeper. So I wouldn't necessarily ever really buy this 3-3-2-2 one, but this 4-1-4 one looks decent, especially kind of the way they're spread out. If you have good defenders and good offensive midfielders, then if you just need like a single striker or forward, then that's a decent looking one. But anyway, let's look into like how you play League Mode. Some of you might not even played it yet. What happens is you get 5 tickets every day, and it refreshes every time you rank up. So like I'm about to rank up, so I would get a refresh here. But otherwise, it refreshes every 24 hours, and we actually just passed the refresh time, so it's pretty far away from me right now. But I have 4 tickets, so let's go in. We'll do a quick match. I'm just gonna auto it to show you guys kind of how it works. So I'm not really gonna try to go for a high score, but you usually get matched based on power level. It seemed like as my power level's gone up, it's almost 200,000 right now. I've noticed even though my score hasn't gone up for the week, I've been being matched up against higher ranked or higher power level people. When you face higher power ranked people, you get a bit of a bonus to your score, but it's not enough to like, you're better getting like winning 4-0 against a lower ranks person than, or lower power level person, than you are winning 2-1 against like a higher power level person. So we're just gonna pick the lowest level power level person here. Actually, we're not gonna pick the lowest. We're gonna pick actually the second lowest, just because I don't really like going up against what's this guy's name? Hyuga. I think it's Hyuga. So we're gonna go up against the Tsubasa instead, and you can boost yourself with the support items, and they're actually pretty cheap. It's like 1,000 metal 1,000 coins, which isn't very much. I'm not gonna bother doing it right now, but you can get like plus 5% points. You can get halftime stamina recovery is up by 30%. Which I don't think is that good, just because this one, I think this one's better. Stamina consumed is 20% less, and I think overall that's better than getting back stamina, a bit more stamina at half. And then crit rate up 5%. This is actually a really good one, because crits can make a big difference, especially when you have like a bad matchup kind of thing. One sec, let me just get rid of this message here. Stuck on our way. So I'm just gonna go kick off. We're just gonna auto this, and then you guys kind of see how the scoring works. One second here, and while this is loading, I'm gonna mute this conversation real quick. Every time I gotta record, I forget to mute conversations. Someday I'll learn how to make YouTube videos. Anyway, so. So yeah, we have about 60k more power level. It's weird though, auto is not that good. Like, it seems like the auto is always better for your opponent than it is for yourself. So I'm expecting we'll win, but it wouldn't surprise me if they score a bit. We got a foul. I find like the higher power level you are, the more often you see fouls. I feel like I never saw them earlier on in the game, but we got another foul. That looks like a goal. Nice. All right, so it's up 1-0. We're about, what, like 20 minutes in? 22 minutes in? And Snyder, for some reason, is not going straight to the net. If he did, he would score. There he goes. So we're up 2-0. What you really want to be going for, you want to be going for shutouts, and you want to be going for hat tricks. And aside from that, just as many goals as possible, really. It seems like there's a few other ways to get points, and we'll kind of go over that as well, but those are the main things, like getting goals and not letting the other team get in goals, which isn't that surprising. That's the whole point of the game. But you really get big bonuses for hat tricks, and you get big bonuses. Oh, go goalie. No, they scored. All right, my shutout's over, but that's all right. Sometimes, like, if I was worried about placement, I would play these manually. But I'm not that worried about it this week, just because it's so competitive, because there's so many people in each tier right now, or in the bottom tier, because everyone's in the bottom tier. Like, kind of starting next week and stuff, I'll be more worried about my actual score and trying to get good scores. And just for this video, it's faster to play with all the animation skipping and stuff. So you'll see, if I go into breakdown, we actually got a pretty good score there. So if we go into breakdown here, you'll see, so I won the match, so I got 10,000. The score difference is 3,000, that's because I won by 3. It's 1,000 for every goal. If you get no goals conceded, that's 2,000 normally. Dominance, I think that's the percentage of the time that you have the ball. Goal rating is usually about 2,000, a little over 2,000 per goal that you get. Hat trick is 5,000 per hat trick. You can get 2 hat tricks and you get 10,000. That's usually a really big boost. Head start bonus is if you score the first goal. Or sorry, head start's if you score the first goal. And I think head start bonus is if you score like consecutive goals without them scoring. So you can get some good points there as well. No substitutes, 1,000. Your own team player rating is based on just whatever your power level is. For me, it's just right around the 10,000 mark. It'll be lower. I think 10,000 is right around 150K. So I'm over that now. I'm almost at 2,000 or 200,000. So I'm getting around 11K now. And then the person I played, the opponent team play rating is around 9,000. Cause he was, I think, 130K. Giant killing, I think that's if you beat someone with a higher power level than you. I haven't tried that yet. That might be worth a lot of points. That might be how you see a lot of people with a lot of points. It's weird though, because I don't really ever see people as an option that have a higher power level than me yet. Maybe that's just because how the placement worked out. And then the other stuff's just kind of like, really, you get like 50 points here and there for like successful passes or dribbles or interceptions, or I got a bunch of free kicks that time, which you don't see that often. So lots of different ways to get points, but it's mostly around goals and not letting in goals. And power level to a certain extent. So you'll see we almost get 1,000 league medals there, and we got quite a bit of club experience as well, so that's nice. And so if you're out of stamina especially, you should be doing even just autoing league mode, especially if you've already got like a half decent score. And there's also a lot of daily achievements that are, missions that revolve around league mode. So we might even get some here. Yeah, like daily, play 2 matches, win a match, and then you get a bunch of league medals there as well. So like now I just got 150, I just got 1,500. And so I'm almost at enough for another art ticket. And who knows, like there's a chance, I think there's a 3% chance, like I think it's like a normal pull rating, that you could get an SSR on those, even on those art plus tickets. So what else did I have to say? I think that's basically it about league mode. Just you should get in there, you should be playing it. Yeah, because even you can see there, even just autoing through it, you can play an auto in like 5 minutes. And like, especially if you're about to rank up. So if I rank up, my tickets are going to refresh. So I might as well use all my tickets right before. It's giving me the club experience, and it's giving me league medals. And then you can get those tickets, or you can get those other, even like money and stuff from it. I definitely think the tickets are probably the best thing to get with it though, unless you need other stuff. Those formations look decent as well. Like maybe by the end of the month, I'll just get those just to have them. The other big thing is online mode, but I think I'm going to save that for another video. This is kind of like the last play mode I haven't touched yet. And then I do still plan on doing some more videos about how to best kind of level up your guys using like skill transfers and everything else. I do want to just mention, because I might not do another video for a day or two, the event going on right now that gives the free Tsubasa. I don't know if I've mentioned this yet in any of my other videos, so I'm going to say now, this challenge one on the far left, it gives really good rewards. So especially if you can do it in shared play, but even if it's not shared play, I really recommend doing this one if you're using your stamina lately, especially if there's no raids or sudden events going on. The challenge Tsubasa one, you can get some really good like SSR books and SSR coaches, and you can get Tsubasa and then level them up and stuff. So I think that's it for this video. Just wanted to do a real quick one. If you're seeing this in the next like 3 hours and you haven't got your league mode in yet for the week, you should do it. But definitely if it's later than that, make sure you do it for next week and start checking that out. Alright guys, hope you found that useful. Hopefully you're enjoying Captain Tsubasa, and I'll see you soon. Thanks for watching. Really appreciate it.